Hi, in this video we are going to see GATE previous year questions with answers for electrical engineering, electrical machines, set number 3. In this set we are going to see 10 different questions from various year. This set mostly will be covering more number of questions in induction motors, okay, induction motors and related things, and only one or two questions from the transformers area, okay. First question. It is desired to measure the parameters of 230 volt bar 115 volt 2 kVA single phase transformer. The following wattmeters are available in a laboratory. Okay, W1 is 250 volt 10 amps low power factor, W2 is 250 volt 5 amps low power factor, W3 is 150 volt 10 amps high power factor, W4 is 150 volt 5 amps high power factor. The wattmeters used in open circuit test and short circuit test of the transformer will be, okay. Here we are going to do a open circuit test and short circuit test in a single phase transformer. The capacity of transformer is 2 kVA, okay. The primary voltage is 230 volt and secondary voltage is 115 volt, okay. And that is we can say high voltage side is 230 volt and low voltage side is 115 volt, okay. Here there are 4 wattmeters are there. Here you can observe 2 wattmeters are low power factor meter and 2 wattmeters are high power factor meter, okay. And you can observe another thing, that the rating of the current rating will be different for W1 and W2, and current rating is different for W3 and W4, okay. And voltage rating of W1 and W2 are same, and W3 W4 is same, okay. Now, in an open circuit test, the purpose of doing an open circuit test is to find out the magnetizing losses. Okay, we have to find out the magnetizing current. So, in an open circuit set, the power factor of operation will be very low. Okay, generally, it will be in the range of 0.2, like it will be in the range of 0.2 to 0.3. It will be in the range of 0.2 to 0.3 power factor of operation. Okay. In a short circuit test, the power factor will be high. It will be coming in the range of 0.5 to 0.6 or 0.7 also will be there sometimes. Okay. So, here we have to select one low power factor meter and one high power factor meter. This low power factor meter is for doing an open circuit test. And high power factor meter is for doing the short circuit test. Okay. And generally, the current for during the no load condition will be 4 to 8% of the full load current, okay. So we can calculate the full load current, okay. It will be coming around, so 2000 divided by 115 into 8%, 8 by 100, so 1.4 amps. So 5 amps wattmeter itself sufficient for the use. So W2 you can select for your operation, okay. And second one is the full load current. We can calculate 2000 divided by 230 equal to 8.7 amps, and power factor will be high power factor. So since it is 8.57 amps, we cannot use a 5 amps wattmeter. W4 we cannot use, so W3 only we can use. So you can select W2 and W3. Choice D is the right answer, okay. Again I am repeating, it is desired to measure the parameters of 230 volt divided by 115 volt 2 kVA single phase transformer. The following wattmeters are available. So in a laboratory we have 4 wattmeters, W1, W2 and W3 and W4, okay. And these 4 wattmeters are, 2 wattmeters are low power factor meter and 2 for high power factor meter. We have to select the correct meter for your usage, okay. If you select the correct meter, the accuracy of operation will be good, okay. So if you select a 5 amps meter for this measurement, it will be very good. If you select a 10 amps meter, your reading will be having error, okay. Some error will be there, so you have to select the wattmeter properly, okay. And generally in an open circuit test, the power factor will be very low. It will be in the range of 0.2, and in short circuit test the power factor will be in the range of 0.5 to 0.6, okay. And current in the open circuit test will be 4 to 8% of the full load current, okay. Next question. In an induction motor, if the air gap is increased, means, okay, So induction motor, how it will operate? Okay, we are giving a three phase supply to the induction motor. When we give a supply to the induction motor, we are giving a supply in the stator winding. Okay, when you give a supply, if the stator winding is closed condition, when we give a three phase supply, it will generate a current in the stator winding. Okay, there will be a current flow in the stator winding. When the current is flowing in the stator winding, it will create a flux, and this flux will be linked to the rotor. Okay, when the rotor is short circuited, okay, short circuited rotor you are using. Okay, when the rotor is short circuited, it will induce a current in the rotor. Because of this induced current in the rotor, okay, sorry, because of the induced voltage in the rotor, it will produce a current. Okay, and that current will produce another flux. This particular flux will oppose the root cause flux, that is a stator flux. Because of that, torque will be produced and motor will be rotating. Okay, and whatever the flux produced in the stator, it will be linking via the air gap to the rotor. Okay, if you increase this air gap between the stator winding and the rotor, okay, because of the increased air gap, it requires more amount of current for generating the required amount of flux. So it will increase the magnetizing current requirement. Okay, so because of the increased magnetizing current requirement, the power factor of the operation will be lowered. Okay, so choice C is the right answer. In an induction motor, if the air gap is increased, the power factor will be lowered. Okay, again I am repeating, we are giving a supply to the stator winding. When we give a supply to the stator winding, if the stator winding is closed condition, okay, it will draw a current. Okay, this current will produce a magnetic flux, revolving magnetic flux. Okay, whenever conductor cuts the revolving magnetic flux, EMF will be induced. That is, in the rotor, there will be an induced EMF because of this revolving magnetic flux in the stator. Okay, this induced EMF will produce a current in the rotor, and that current will produce another flux. Okay, that particular flux will oppose the revolving magnetic flux. Okay, because of the torque, okay, the motor will be rotating. If the air gap is increased, it requires more amount of magnetizing current to produce the same amount of flux in the rotor. Okay, so power factor of operation of the motor is reduced. If an induction motor is run at the above synchronous speed, it acts as a, okay, you are operating an induction motor above the synchronous speed, it will become a generator, okay, because of the negative slip. Okay, so if the induction motor runs at the above the synchronous speed, it will act as an induction generator. So choice B is the right answer. The following starting method of an induction motor is inferior in the view of poor starting torque per ampere in the line drawn. Okay, DOL first is direct online starting. In direct online starting, the starting current will be almost 5 to 6 times the rated current. Okay, it will produce heavy torque, high starting torque. And auto transformer starting also will produce more starting torque. Star delta starting also, it will produce 2 to 3 times the starting torque. Okay, series inductor method of starting. Okay, because series inductor method of starting, it will produce a starting torque which is very lesser than the normal starting torque. Okay, so choice C is the right answer. The following starting torque method of induction motor is very inferior, okay, because of the poor starting torque is series inductor method of starting. Okay, generally in industry, you can see for some application, they will be using direct online starters. Okay, and star delta starters will be used if the starting torque requirement is 2 to 3 times, okay, and direct online starting will be generally adopted. And auto transformer starting also will use. Series inductor method of starting will be normally not used in the industries. It will be very rare. Okay. If a 400 volt 50 hertz star connected 3 phase circuit cage induction motor is operated from a 400 volt 75 hertz supply, the torque that the motor can now provide while drawing the rated current from the supply. Okay. So here they have mentioned that instead of 50 hertz, they are giving a 75 hertz, and they have mentioned that the supply is 400 volt, okay, and the rated current. While drawing a rated current, if we increase the frequency, the speed of operation will increase. Okay, generally torque and speed are inversely proportional. Okay, because in inversely proportional, you are increasing the frequency, it increases the speed, so torque will reduce. Choice A is the right answer. Okay, if a 400 volt 50 hertz torque connected 3 phase Kurl cage induction motor is operated from 400 volt 75 hertz supply, the torque that the motor can provide while drawing the rated current from the supply, okay, it's reducing because torque is inversely proportional to the speed of the motor. The type of single phase induction motor, okay, having the highest power factor at full load will be, since the capacitor start, capacitor will be there only during the starting time. Okay, in the capacitor run, capacitor will be always connected with the winding while running also, because capacitor is always connected with the winding, the power factor of operation will be higher. Okay, so capacitor run type of motor will be having higher power factor. Okay, the type of single phase induction motor is having highest power factor at full load is capacitor run type. Okay, the slip of an induction motor is, does not depend on, generally if you see the equivalent circuit, okay, in the equivalent circuit the rotor speed will be having an impact in the slip, synchronous speed also will be affecting, shaft torque also will be there, and core loss component will not have any impact with the slip. So choice D is the right answer. The slip of an induction motor is normally depend on rotor speed, depend on synchronous speed, and depend upon the shaft torque, and it is independent of core loss component. The slip of an induction motor normally does not depend upon core loss component. Okay, for a single phase capacitor start induction motor, which of the following statements are true? Okay, the capacitor is used for power factor improvement. See, capacitor here, it is normally used for starting purpose. In a single phase motor, there will not be any revolving magnetic flux. Okay, in order to create a revolving magnetic flux, we require minimum two windings. Okay, so that's why we use, in a single phase motor, two windings will be there, main winding and auxiliary winding will be there. Generally there will be a capacitor, it will be connected so that it will create a phase difference between these two windings. Okay, so in a single phase capacitor start motor, the capacitance is used for creating a phase difference between the two windings. It is not used for power factor improvement. Okay, so choice A is wrong. The direction of rotation can be changed by reversing the main winding. Yes, if you change the connection in the main winding alone, the direction will be reversed. That is true. A direction of rotation cannot be changed, so it is wrong. The direction of rotation can be changed by interchanging the supply terminal. If you interchange supply terminal, direction will never be changed in a single phase motor. Okay, so choice B is the right answer. Single phase induction motors are not a self starting. In order to make them start, we use capacitors. These capacitors will actually, the winding will be split into two parts. One is main winding and another is auxiliary winding. Okay, we are connecting a capacitor so that phase difference between these two winding will be generated, and because of that motor will be rotating. Okay, so for a single phase motor, okay, single phase capacitor start induction motor, the correct statement is direction of rotation can be changed by reversing the main winding terminals. Under no load condition, if the applied voltage to the induction motor is reduced from the rated voltage to the half of the value, what will happen? If we reduce the rated, if we reduce the voltage, half of the voltage, the current drawn will be increasing. Okay, because it is under no load condition, it requires some minimum amount of magnetizing current. Okay, if you reduce, it will draw a minimum amount of magnetizing current. If you reduce the voltage for the same power, it will draw more current. Okay, the stator current will increase. Okay, and speed will drop. Okay, under no load condition, if the applied voltage of an induction motor is reduced, the speed decreases and the stator current increases. When the voltage is halved, the slip becomes 4 times and hence speed is decreasing. Larger the slip, so current is slightly increasing. Okay, because of the high slip, the current is increasing. So choice A is the right answer. In a single phase motor driving a fan load, the reason for having high resistance rotor is to achieve quick acceleration. Okay, the purpose in a single phase induction motor driving a fan load, the reason for having high resistance rotor is to achieve the quick acceleration. Starting torque is generally proportional to the rotor resistance. If the rotor resistance is high, okay, it will give a quick acceleration. Because of that only we are using. Okay, so actually you can remember in induction motor, squirrel cage induction motor is there, slip ring induction motor is there. Slip ring motor, induction motor will give you high starting torque because of the high rotor resistance. In a squirrel cage, the performance will be very good during running. The starting torque will be less than the slip ring motor. In a slip ring, performance will be very good at the starting, and running performance will be, when comparing with squirrel cage, it will be having some losses. Okay. Just try this question and give the answer in your comment box. Okay. Here there are two groups is given. Group 1, they have given the application, and group 2, they have mentioned the type of motor. Which type of motor will be suited for which application? Okay, so you have to select the correct combination and you have to do it. Okay, answer for this particular set, particular question will be given in the next set. Okay, if you like this video, means press the like button. Okay, if you have any clarification, please contact us. Okay, thanks for listening. Okay, all the best for your examination. Thank you.